I keep forgetting I'm the away team and I'm looking over at the home team. Kind of funny, huh? I keep passing.
That's Cincinnati, JD.
No, it ain't.
It showed Cincinnati on my screen.
It's Denver.
No, not your playbook, your defensive playbook. All right, never mind.
All right. It can be a battle of the young guns. Thinking,
that's if we play. Well, my shit's moving fast, so.
Yeah, it's gonna be a battle of Drew Locke and.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. The two teams emerging from their respective tunnels a minute ago to the approval of this Baltimore crowd. They're all set as their Ravens will match up with the Denver Broncos. Justin Tucker.
Ain't my uniform pretty cool there, Will?
Yeah. What's that, the throwbacks?
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. Looks kind of like the Florida Gators uniform.
I think it looks like a mix between Clemson and Gators. Okay, that was a bad lag.
He's got it, the tight end Jeff Heuermann.
What the fuck? God damn, that motherfucker didn't want to go down. Holy shit.
This game progresses because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
Lay the fuck down, Phillip.
It's so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage to go in the middle as well. And he's got it.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On first down, right back to Lindsey. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage.
I'm trying to pick a play, but not on me though.
What's it lagging?
Yeah, I'm the call screen.
All right. Just don't snap it. I'll go ahead and decline it. I would have declined a penalty, JD.
So he steps back and calls timeout.
Yeah.
We'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Not a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't have been an asshole about it.
Let's go. 15, Lonnie. 15, Lonnie.
Well, like half of the other people in the league will have been.
Yeah.
On second and 11 now. Lock. There goes a deep ball. End zone. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down.
That was not the way it was supposed to go. I kind of hyper-speeded backwards, so it made it way behind
incomplete pass
the guy.
Last play,
the guy.
He'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing his lock on third down. Going for the deep ball. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down. That's already the third time they've looked his way on this opening drive.
Ooh.
He's caught one of the three.
Do you have a chance?
Continue to go in that production. It feels like they think they've got something good going there, and they think those numbers are going to increase.
Oh! Oh, God, it didn't go through. I thought it went through.
It ran out of gas at the end, and this will remain a scoreless game. I thought it went for a two, so. Opening drive looked good for a moment. Are you lagging? Being turned
away thanks to I keep saying that and those especially hurt when you come you're experiencing network issues. You're trying to get things to go your way early, and now you suffer a setback right out of the gate.
Two sides to every coin. This is the bad side of missing the 58-yarder. Now they start at the 48. And the former Heisman winner, this is Mark Ingram. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Yeah, you almost had me. He ran right through Harris.
Often alters the normal spacing and run fits. Yeah. And leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Eight yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Now it's Jackson. Caught here by Griffin. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the gun, it's Jackson.
Jackson cannot
get away. Von Miller.
He'll go down. Von Miller doing what he does best with a sack.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice game.
You didn't know that was coming.
They gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Throwing on second and long. Jackson, open man is the tight end, Nick Boyle. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. From the gun on third down, Jackson. Flushed out right. He's got it to Ingram, complete. And they have the first down with that gain of 4 yards. They'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown.
That was a good read option right there.
As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Defensively, they told us that the top priority was defending option plays this week, but here on the very first drive, the defense broke down a bit.
It certainly did, and it's really not a surprise because defending option football is difficult. You have to think too much. Most of the time, you just react to what you see and you play fast. Here you're reacting, you're processing. Do I have the back? Do I have the quarterback? Who do I take? Do I take on a blocker? And next thing you know, he's in the end zone.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down at the 21-yard line.
Not too bad of a record.
The Broncos onto the field ready to start their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time? Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Now a carry for Lindsey. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play out.
No way to escape, and he goes down. Matt Judon just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. And now Matt Judon
maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining.
Spike ball.
On third and long, it's Locke. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Domada Peko racks up the sack.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. Five defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the, proper price.
Okay, how much were they? A dime? What were they?
15 cents.
Now on fourth down, they throw the deep ball, but it winds up to be incomplete. Boy, a real head-scratcher there. And that will force a turnover on downs. So first and 10 now from the 30. Jackson going to get this out to Brown. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 13 and a Raven first down. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. It's complete to Snead. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. They'll look to run with Ingram, and he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. Play 3 of the drive, not as successful. They go backwards after those 2 first down gains. Second and goal from the 6 this time. Jackson. And that is caught, but he will come out of bounds, says the side judge. Incomplete. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. I got you. They'll try and run. Ingram. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to bring up a 4th and goal. Let's think here. You're still just in the second quarter. You taking the 3 points?
I am taking the 3 points, and I'm just relying on my defense here. Show me I have a little confidence in them, and let the offense know, nice drive. Come back next time. We'll go get 6 then, but for now, we'll take the 3.
A good drive gets them inside the 5, but they could not punch it in.
And credit the defense, too. Make sure that that happens, because that was the old bend but don't break approach. Made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And on that last drive, Whitford on 4th turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on 4th down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened.
Wow. I blew that. I blew the sack and then the interception.
Yeah.
A good pick up there of 20 yards.
That was fucking terrible.
Own 40 to the other 40. The gain of 20 leads to first and 10. On first and 10, it's Lindsey. Tackle made there by Josh Bynes.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now, we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense. I'm going back to you.
Look at this, a tight end carry. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
2 yard gain.
They'll need to get it to the
30. It was on the first 7-yard line.
This is third down. They look to throw. It's Locke.
Wow. Come on. I hit the button way
time for his second sack of the
evening. Oh, God. Here we go with this fucking long-ass field goal attempt.
I mean, you know me. Normally.
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. It's picked up. A live ball here, remember.
Oh.
They're not going to get it.
Block field goal.
As the Ravens push further out in front. We talk about it a lot. One of the dangers of the long field goal, you got to kind of hit it low and drive it.
God,
that makes it susceptible to a block.
That sucks.
You didn't really need to.
And how about how well they did on the
You didn't really need to think and string this game because it's flat.
That type of a scrambling situation. Someone will clip. Someone will block below the waist.
My internet's not lagging.
Name it. In this case, though, that didn't happen. They formed it up, and he took it all the way back for a touchdown.
And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line.
I had the same kind of internet you do.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
We know, but don't let me finish.
Okay, okay.
You're down 3 scores already. You've done nothing offensively. Nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good
combination. It wasn't even
I think you just
the play that I normally call.
Yeah, but you fucking got it.
You said this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
Come on. Let me snap the ball.
Ready? Block now on first down. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. He was trying to find Noah Fant, the tight end.
That was bad.
Second down.
It wouldn't let me snap at first.
I think you and I agree.
Well, that's because you had to bring a guy in motion.
We put Baltimore number one, certainly in the AFC. But
it didn't actually snap. It wouldn't let me throw it right away.
For that Lamar Hunt trophy.
Well, tradition and us not wanting to be wrong dictates that we say New England next, and rightly so, because of the number of Lombardi trophies they've won, how they've always played at this time of year. But the bottom line to me is the prime contenders right now for Baltimore, Kansas City.
Good D.
Just got together, the defense is playing better, and Buffalo really showed me something when they beat Pittsburgh in Pittsburgh on a Sunday night in week 15.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Block will try again on second down. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end.
You whiffed on that first
pick.
Yeah, no, I probably could have. I could have probably knocked the ball loose if I would have hit it on time.
Nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Here's Locke to throw. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Brandon Carr. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line. Philip Lindsay, the intended target. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
I just kept going with the people
I
throwing to.
Oh, you bitch.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the three-point
kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract.
No!
Taken down. Ingram taken down of the end zone. It's a safety. And you know the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point.
I really did, Brandon.
But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Oh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points.
But bring
if
in
I
the house.
Kept going to
that, the ready to start their next
if I would have went to that same player every time, you wouldn't have stopped him.
We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back
out.
Oh,
hey, that was a lucky hit.
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that.
You don't know that, right?
Did he say that?
Yeah.
But he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be.
You know, when he catches
it, trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Into heavy traffic, and it's
overthrow.
And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
I can't see anything.
Second interception
for
him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it.
And he is into the end zone.
I don't know how hard I hit Lamar, but it looks like he went down pretty good.
Yeah, he definitely did get clobbered.
As the Ravens push further out in front. So the quarterback drops to throw, looks over, and boom, a guy that wide open. He has to be thinking, wait a minute, this is some kind of a dream. This is too easy.
Yeah, a great dream. One you don't want to wake up from. But for the defense, almost feels like there was a bust in coverage.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
Bring the heat.
They sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it?
The offensive
coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke.
Doesn't matter.
Had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Back to the air on second down. It's locked. Nowhere to escape, and he goes
down. Hey,
okay.
I don't know why he pump faked it.
On EA Sports.
I seriously don't know why he pump faked it.
At halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. Now on third down, that pass knocked down. In the backfield and incomplete.
He jumped high as shit.
Earl Thomas, the all-pro safety, knocking it free.
Come on. Stupid. Jesus. There's one thing for sure. I don't lag this bad in Call of Duty.
If it don't let you pick, don't waste your time out.
Yeah, playoff.
Don't worry about it.
And now the punt team couldn't get ready in time, and this is going to be a delay.
You picking a play now?
Trying to. For some reason, it put me in shotgun plays, and I didn't want a shotgun. Weird,
so fourth and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it. They do go for it. It's locked. Nowhere to escape.
I hit a button way before you got there.
And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. First down there, but it's incomplete. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. And a pitch to Ingram. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
The chance of this play has to give
starting field position a real threat. This is third and long. Throwing is Jackson, and he's gonna go down. He sacked back at the 24. Von Miller, his second sack of the night.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking, but to me it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play action sack. This is taken about 7 yards deep.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You
can't hold that. Thinking. Hyman, can't hold that.
Analytics will tell you. Try and score when given the opportunity.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
There we go.
I got that hit stick that time.
Now
you gotta worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give him another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
To throw on third down. Lock.
I missed the sack.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
The three straight incompletions. Going for it. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth down with Locke. And this is incomplete.
I can't play this game
move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. Here we go. This is Ingram on first and 10. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. Second and 5 now. Jackson looking left side and he's got a man. It's Griffin. They'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A 20-yard touchdown as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Tucker with the extra point, and a rout is on here in this first half. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
You pick a play yet?
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Come on,
Locked again here on second and 10. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. So his struggles just continuing here in the first half, throwing the football, Charles. Now three interceptions.
It is flagging.
They're just great plays by the defense. There's a sense that maybe he's a little careless with the football now. So some of the great coaches in the past, you know, they've always said,
I got to fix my connection.
I can't teach you, obviously,
well,
because you're not listening. So maybe the bench can teach you. He's got to be careful now. He might get pulled.
A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up. Got a man. It's caught. For a Ravens touchdown, Willie Snead, as the first half is winding down, as his guys continue to pour it on.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the halves.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And this fake extra point attempt failed big time. Not only did they not get it, they went backwards. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone.
You want to back out and fix your internet?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you're going to need to, because you're about to play that other guy soon.
Yeah, I better just fix it now and game it.
We got a game in like an hour.